Hello, math class. This is Mr. Jacobs, and we're looking at lesson 6.1, writing decimals as percents and writing percents as decimals. So, taking a look at our textbook and reading what we see, the key idea is to write a percent as a decimal, you want to remove the percent symbol, and then you can either divide that number by 100 or just move the decimal point two places to the left. So here's a great example. Here's 23%. And when I see 23%, I see the percent symbol. So you also see a hidden decimal to the right of the three in red. You can either divide by 100 or you just move that decimal place two units to the left. One, two. It ends up here. See that? Of course, you always put a zero to the left of the decimal if there is no other number there, so that you don't think you're looking at 23. Putting a zero there lets you know that it's 0.23 or 23 hundredths. So from 23% as a decimal, that's how you do it. 23% to a decimal. Okay? Move the decimal to the left. Now, here's some examples. Write 52% as a decimal. Again, 52%. There is the hidden decimal here. Move the decimal to the left, two places to the right. Ends up here. And there you have it. See it? There's also 7%. And this one's great. I want to show this one by hand because I think it's pretty important to see what's going on. So 7%, okay, is equal to 7% of the decimal. But when you move this decimal two places to the left, here we go, watch this. There's that decimal. One, two. That second move, if you were to draw these hoops, there is a blank spot, an empty spot. That first decimal here, it's right in front of the seven, but now here there's a blank spot. So what do you do with that blank spot? Well, you add a zero, okay? So this becomes 0.07. So anytime you move a decimal to the left and there is a missing digit, you add a zero there, which is this rule here, look. When moving the decimal point, you may need to place one or more zeros in the number, okay? Yes, may need to move that decimal. And when you move it, if there's an empty space, you add a zero. And there's plenty of examples of that. Like for instance, let's try 9%, you know? 9%, you know, it's the same thing as 9.0%. You've got to move this decimal to the left two spots. Right, so it would be 0.09. See that? And that empty spot here represents a zero. Okay? Yeah, so that's how you do it. And so we end up with 7%, and that is the decimal form. Alrighty? Then we have a diagram there that explains, you know, hundred grid, right? A square grid, and you have 52 out of 100, 52%, 7 out of 100, 7%. Alrighty. I really like this one here, number 3. Thanks, it's a great question. There's a decimal here. If you move it over to the left, two places, end up at 1.07. And that's the decimal form of 107. So you see what's going on? To change a percent to a decimal, move the decimal place two units to the left. All right. Now, what about writing a decimal as a percent? Well, the idea there is that you're going to either multiply the decimal by 100 or just move the decimal two places to the right. Then add a percent symbol. And so there you have it. So if I have this decimal here, And here it is, there's that decimal. And if you move it two places to the right, right? One, two, it ends up here at a decimal place. Now remember, all numbers, right, that are whole numbers, like 36, 57, there's always a hidden decimal. We don't write 36.0, we just don't do that, we write 36, right? So there is a hidden decimal there, okay? And we don't necessarily have to write it. We just write the whole number and the percent symbol. So 36 hundredths is 36%. So when moving a decimal to the right two places, you are changing the decimal to a percent. And here's some great examples. Again, look at that there, 47 hundredths with a decimal to the right two spots, ends up right here. Again, that's the way you write it, without the hidden decimal. Now this one here, you may have to add a zero place value, right? So you have 1.8, when you move that over two spots, right? Move this over two spots, 1, 2, there it is. So you end up with this 1.80, decimal is there. We don't have to write that decimal. And there it is, 180%. And again, that's what's going on here. Okay, so I hope that makes a lot of sense, what's going on. Simple rules, right? Example 3 says writing a fraction as a percent and a decimal. All right. So writing a fraction as a percent and a decimal. So we saw something like this before, right? We saw that if we take a look at some examples here that are, let's just read them, see what it says. It says on a math test, you get 92 out of a possible 100 points. Which of these following is not another way of expressing 92 out of 100? Well, 92 out of 100 we know is 92%, right? Right? So let's look at 92 out of 100. How do you express that? Well, there's, first of all, that's a phrase. 92 out of 100 would be a fraction, right? So to represent that fraction out of, as a percent, this makes sense. 92 out of 100 is 92%. That makes sense. Remember that 92 out of 100, 92%, is also this here as a decimal. Remember how we change that? But is there another way to represent that fraction as a reduced fraction? Well, let's think about it. Is 92 out of 100 23 over 25? Well, I know that you can divide 100 by 4, right? Can you divide 92 by 4? And you can. Let me ask Siri. 92 divided by 4. And I don't think she has access here. But if I were to divide this by 4, that's how I get 25. And divide 92 by 4, that's how I get 23. So that's the simplified form of 92 out of 100, which is still 92%. So this is correct, right? This is correct. And this is correct. The one that must be incorrect is this one. Which one is not another way of representing 92 out of 100? It's C. So again, you've got to be really comfortable with reducing fractions, rewriting a percent as a decimal, and verifying what you see makes sense. And so here's some other questions where you have 25%, writing that as a decimal makes sense. It's also this fraction, writing that as a decimal makes sense, right? Whoa, lost it there. Here we go. 25 and 21 out of 25, writing those as decimals, right? And so what you're doing is you're, looks like we're gonna compare these decimals, these percents, these fractions to find out some type of relationship, but we'll go ahead and skip that. We don't need to necessarily solve this particular question. Okay? And then, yeah, that's it. Those are the examples that we wanted to talk about. And so, remember, two key concepts. When you move a decimal to the left, you are changing the percent to a decimal, correct? And when you move a decimal to the right, two places, you're changing the decimal to a percent. So I hope that helps. Like I always say, study hard, learn a lot. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.